even then I didn't know that I had this talent.
Uh-huh.
You know. So this really came about like in the 67.
Uh-huh.
When a schoolmate of mine, Bonnie Lee, I always remember Bonnie Lee because he was the first one who introduced me to the record.
Wow.
So that was when, subconsciously, I knew anything anyway.
Uh-huh.
But what really started the whole interest is when I came out with it, In the Mood for Love, and I saw the interest.
Right.
That stimulated people then. I think I recognize what I have.
Yeah. Now, you started out singing with a group early on?
Originally, I started out solo, which I did two songs.
Oh, uh-huh.
Didn't make any impact at the time.
And those were for Bonnie Lee as a producer?
Those were with Bonnie Lee.
And what songs were they?
Shep and the Limelighters, Daddy's Home.
Yes.
And Little Boy Blue.
Oh, yes. Curtis Mayfield song. Yeah.
Yeah.
Great.
The interest came when I went over to the with the Techniques.
Right. But you sang with another group before you sang with the Techniques, right?
Well, when we were growing up, we had a group named, we didn't make any record. Sheridan's.
I see. Just local people that you sang.
Right.
With.
But yeah. Then I wasn't the focus of that.
I see. Well,
I was just learning little bits and pieces.
Uh-huh.
I had no interest at the same time.
Yeah.
But since we had nothing to do then, we would rehearse sometime in the evening.
Yes.
Nothing, anything to talk about.
Now, the Techniques was a group that a lot of great singers passed through that group at different times, as we had groups like the Temptations here, where there were various mm-hmm. singers who sang with them at different times. And so a lot of people know some of those early Techniques songs with Slim Smith, but you came into the group after Slim Smith left.
Yes.
Yeah, uh-huh. And you had some big, big hits with the Techniques.
Yes. That was when, that's where my old emphasis started.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of the Techniques recognized song came when I was leader.
Yes, true.
They shouldn't get it mixed up that Slim Greatest Hits came with the Uniques.
Yes.
And not with Techniques.
And you actually sang with the Uniques a little bit too, right?
No, I didn't.
Really? Because there is a CD that has a couple of songs that say Pat Kelly and the Uniques on them.
Bonnie Lee produced it, both of us, at some time or the other.
Uh-huh.
You have this strategy of changing song, name of singers.
As he did with the band sometimes, say the Agrolites when it was the Soul Syndicate, this kind of thing.
You get the message.
Yeah, very interesting. We're talking live in the studio with Pat Kelly. We're going to play some more music from Pat Kelly and come back and speak with him again, one of Jamaica's greatest singers. This is Pat Kelly. We started that set with a Black Swan 7-inch single called It's a Good Day and played a Techniques song in between called Festival 68, also featuring Pat Kelly on lead. And we're speaking live in the studio right now with Mr. Pat Kelly. Jumping around in time a little because you had so many great hit records over such a long period of time.
I'm really amazed and I'm really happy. This is one of my most happiest interview. I'm not kidding.
Well, thank you so much.
Yes. I can see that you're a collector because you came up with the original versions on the copy of the songs.
Right. Yes.
Not a regurgitated copy.
Yes.
The original copy.
True, true. Yeah, yeah.
And I was so happy to.
Yeah, so much great music going all the way back. And, right. And same way when I first got into reggae, one of the great Jamaican voices, and really there are some great singers come out of Jamaica in that era, in that time, you know.
Yes.
But and it's interesting to me too because you and I are about the same age, and this music is also bounces off of the great American music that I grew up listening to. You mentioned a song like Daddy's Home. You've covered
right.
tunes like The Great Pretender. We're talking about the influences like Curtis Mayfield and mm-hmm. The Impressions, you know. Coming from that great music, but But as a Jamaican artist, you brought another element into it and made this music even greater in a way, and gave it life again, you know, and for that, I thank you.
Thank you very much. I remember we came, my voice at the time, like in the 67, was a fresh, we call it fresh and new.
Yes.
Fresh voice.
Right.
No one had the tone at that time.
Right, right.
Decades
and,
after.
And no one's had it since.
Thank you. Decades after, we came up with another outstanding voice, Sanchez.
Ah.
Sanchez in this time was Pat Kelly in that time.
That's very interesting.
And that's a very outstanding voice. If you listen to the Sanchez quality, it's different.
Yes.
It's fresh in this time, like when I came in the early, it was fresh.
Yeah. Now, you had actually, that record is one of the ones that features some strings, and you really were the first artist. You came with this song, How Long?
Right.
That was a big, big hit in England. I think it was like a number three on the pop charts.
We're not
talking about when there were reggae charts later, but
yes.
But really a great big chart record.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Great puller.
And that's one of the kind of interesting things about your career, too, is you came in the Rocksteady era, singing with the vocal groups.
Mm-hmm.
You came with some great early reggae tunes when the music started to change, but you're one of the foundation artists for that Lovers Rock style that hit so big in England as well.
Definitely. And what was interesting or is interesting is that I'm original. I used to like writing and still writing songs. So I didn't just like copy songs. I like to create my own interests. And that, I think, is what's taken me through to this era.
Uh-huh. Right. And you're from that era where people created original songs for original rhythms instead of just rolling a rhythm and having 50 versions on that rhythm as happened in later years. Although, even in those early days, there are some great rhythms that get used by the Melodians and you, Roy, used a few times like that. But still, that originality and the innovation and still carrying the tradition of the quality of the melody and the lyric that actually is saying something, whether it's saying something sweet in a love song or whether it's saying something, a message has come, you know, in the Roots era, we would say.
And what was interesting, I always add my input to the song.
Uh-huh.
I never just copy. I add something to somebody else's creativity.
Yes.
So you wouldn't try to compare both songs because they are different.
Uh-huh. Right.
I learned that if you copy something and add some other interest to it,
yes.
Then you wouldn't be labeled as one trying to copy a song.
Uh-huh.
Because to copy is to do something identical as the original.
Right.
I tried not to do that.
Right. This is KPFK 90.7 Los Angeles, 98.7 Santa Barbara, 93.7 San Diego, and 99.5 Ridgecrest, China Lake. Heard worldwide at kpfk.org. I'm Chuck Foster. We're talking live in the studio with Pat Kelly, one of the great Jamaican singers of all times. Now, there kind of came a time, though, when you took a step back from singing. You actually worked at Channel 1 as an engineer for a while.
I didn't work at Channel 1, but I worked at other studios like King Tubby's.
You worked at Tubby's studio.
Right, Randy's studio.
Uh-huh.
I did a little stint at Dynamic.
Uh-huh.
Joe Gibbs.
And Joe Gibbs. Right. Well, yeah, you did that one album, I Wish It Would Rain, at Joe Gibbs. That was in that time.
Yeah, maybe. But I was asked to sitting at Channel 1 as an engineer, but I didn't take the offer.
So you had a background in electrical engineering is kind of
That's what I studied for.
Yeah.
I went to school for that.
So when you worked as an engineer in the studios, because I'm always fascinated by, for instance, in your early recording, you recorded at Duke Reed's studio.
Yes.
And when you recorded at Duke Reed's studio, maybe you could give us a little idea, because we didn't have the chance to be there. What was it like? Who might have been some of the musicians that played there? Was Duke Reed in the studio?
Yes, Duke Reed and the musicians like Tommy McCook and P. people like that. Yes. Ernie Ranglin.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Yes, Hugh Malcolm, which was yes. one of the great Jamaican drummers uh-huh. that nobody really talk a lot about.
Uh-huh.
Hugh Malcolm.
Yes.
But he was one of the outstanding musicians from that era.
Yeah, great, great.
And then I went there and saw like people like John Holt.
Yes.
Along with the, what's the name of John Holt?
Paragons.
The Paragons.
Yes.
Alton Ellis.
Uh-huh.
Opton Lewis.
Great.
Sizz.
Yeah.
And people like that.
Yeah,
Melodians.
Wonderful. Yeah, wonderful, wonderful.
So although I was much older than my peers, I went there later. All of these guys were singing long before me.
Yes.
I really started uh-huh. late.
Right, right. Well, you caught up fast.
Yes. Yeah.
So as an engineer then working in the studios, what might be some of the records that we would know that you would have worked on?
Oh, dear. I've done so many.
Sessions, yeah. Uh-huh.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, then...
Bonnie Wailers.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Gregory Isaacs.
Yes.
Yes, and, you know, Slim...
I think Gregory Isaacs, one of his first records, his first record, as far as I remember, was actually on the flip side of one of your songs, so...
Is that so?
Yeah, yeah, you have the... I'll dig this single out. You have the A side, and he has the B side.
I think that came from Phil Pratt.
That is Phil Pratt, and I have it on the Faith English single, the one I played right at the start here, Summertime, is the A side. All I Have is Love by Gregory Isaacs is the B side.
That's Phil Pratt.
Yeah. So Phil Pratt, another producer that you worked with, besides Bunny Lee. So tell me some of the other producers you worked with then.
Ozzy Hibbert.
Yes, uh-huh.
One of another outstanding producers.
Right.
And...
I know it's not easy to just jump in and start snapping off some of these names.
No. Well, I think that's Ozzy Hibbert, Phil Pratt,
uh-huh.
Bonnie Lee, Channel One, Joe Hookim.
Yes, Jojo Hookim. Uh-huh.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
I did a couple of songs with
Now, we've heard a story. It'd be great to... hear your version of this, but we've heard a story that there came a time when the Beatles wanted to sign you to their label.
That's that's a fact, but honestly, please.
Okay, understood.
Yeah, that was really true, but could I skip it?
Yeah, okay. Okay. Well, we're going to play some more music from Pat Kelly, and we're going to come back and talk with him live some more. Pat Kelly doing a show... that's tonight, his birthday bash with the Delirians, 2,000 tons of TNT, and the B-Sharps at the Big Cheese, formerly Riverside Brewing Company, 3397 Mission Avenue in Riverside. That's an all-ages show. Doors open at 7. Junior, would you come over and get on a mic? You tell me about the show you were telling me about coming up, also another show. We've got Junior Francis here, and he's going to tell us about another show coming up that you can catch Pat Kelly in. Welcome.
Big respect, sir. Well, actually, this one is in Mexico City, so I'm inclined to believe that not very many people...
Well, we have online listeners, too, so...
yes, sir. Well, first time we were in Tijuana this past Friday night.
Uh-huh.
It turned out extremely well. As a matter of fact, Pat didn't want to come back. People in Mexico, in particular Mexico City, are just now discovering rocksteady and ska.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, so that's an open
Jamaican
market.
Music.
Yeah, open
yeah.
market.
Well, and Pat, this is kind of interesting, too, because your career had a definite resurgence when the Lover's Rock style came along, but you're another one of these artists that now that there is a great interest in the early Jamaican music, a lot of people want to really hear you doing that. I can remember when Justin Hines used to tour and play nothing but reggae, and then there came a point where... they started playing pure rock steady. The funny thing with Justin Hines being he had recorded all those songs in both styles, so essentially he was doing the same set, but in the other style. So the same thing has kind of happened with you, though, where a lot of people have tuned in to this classic early music. Do you find yourself doing more of your early tunes these days?
Definitely, especially when I'm on tour. And the transitions works like that because you have to leave from A to B. And or then you can come back from B to A.
Uh-huh.
So it's a back and forth thing. So you're still in the arena, whichever door you want to walk through.
And the music just kept coming for all the years. Brought in some albums here from many different eras from Pat Kelly. Mm-hmm. As you've kept this classic style but continued to do the work, and we've been blessed to have the opportunity to see you out in Southern California
at
some great shows, too. So it's wonderful for an artist who helped establish things from so early and worked so hard in the music business. And we know, as we're talking, looking through some of these 7-inch singles and things, that there's the recompense isn't always so great or so immediate for you.
That's true. And for a lot of other people, too.
True,
you know?
Yes, yeah, yeah. And yet the music have spread around the world as a result, even as a result of the piracy sometimes,
right,
that goes on. And so, you know... Still, it's great to have so much good music, you know, yeah, and good music out there over the years. And I certainly, I don't have it all. I mean, I know you put out albums, early albums, that I've never been able to track down, too.
That's true.
But yeah,
what's good about it is out of evil sometimes comes for good.
Uh-huh. Yes. Yeah.
Can I say that?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. I want to thank you so much for coming in and visiting with us. It's so great. Such an honor to have you here.
Thank you. I really enjoy this because you take me real back.
Yes.
Real, real back in time.
All right. Excellent. You know, it's funny because many of us in America, unlike those of you from Jamaica or people who grew up in England, we didn't get a chance to hear some of this music when it first came out. We had to play catch up in the 70s to the music from the 60s, you know, and yet that you have new young people coming in all the time now who are going back to that time, back to that great music of that time. And that just shows you that this music is for all time, for all people.
Definitely.
Yes.
Definitely.
Pat Kelly, thank you so much. And we'll go out with this tune from Mr. Pat Kelly called The Time Has Come.
Comes a time when every man's heart gets weak.